This is Jim. He mows lawns. In his first week mowing lawns, Jim buys $10 worth of gasoline, which will last him for 2 weeks. Jim then goes and mows a lawn. He isn't paid for mowing the lawn yet. In week two, Jim goes and mows the lawn again. This week, Jim is paid $20 for the 2 weeks of work from the owner of the lawn. What is the story of Jim's income? What would his income statement for each week look like? In week one, Jim received $0 in cash, and he spent $10 of cash on his expenses. His total for week one was -$10. In week two, Jim received $20 in cash, and he did not spend any cash on his expenses. His week two total is $20 of income. In total, he lost $10 in week one, and he made $20 in week two. The story, as told here, tells us literally what happened in Jim's business. The name for this method of telling the story is called cash basis accounting. This is because it literally tells us how cash happens. If you were an investor, and Jim's story was told using the cash basis as seen here, would you want to invest in this business? In reality, if we reflect on Jim's story, we could conclude that over the 2 week period, Jim earned a total of $20 mowing lawns and paid a total of $10 in expenses, thereby earning $10 in total profit. It would be more representative of the business to say that the business earned $5 in each week. Rather than seeing the story told on a cash basis, an investor might be better served if Jim's story was told in a more representative way, rather than showing how activities literally happened from week to week. In order for investors to make a decision about a business, they usually want the story to be told using what is called accrual basis accounting. Accrual accounting is a way to tell a company's story so that it more effectively shows how a company is either making a profit or losing money during a particular period. Accrual accounting is based on two rules. The first rule is that revenue is shown on the books when it is earned, without regard to when cash happens. The second rule is that expenses are not written on the income statement until they are actually incurred or used. The goal is to match expenses with the revenue that they helped the business to earn. If Jim's story was going to be told using these two rules, how would it be told? First, in week one, how much money was earned? We do not care how much cash he received. We only care how much he earned. Even though he has not gotten paid yet, he has still earned $10 in week one. The same goes for week two. He earned another $10. He earned $10 in each week. Next, how much of the $10 he spent on gas should be recognized in week one, and how much should be recognized in week two? Jim used half of the gasoline in each week. Therefore, $5 is shown as an expense in week one, and $5 is shown as an expense in week two. The business earned $5 in each week. This is accrual accounting. As seen, by using accrual accounting, we have more effectively shown the activity of the business for investors to be able to judge the business. Accrual accounting allows us to show how much was actually earned and how much was actually used in each week, so that we have a more representative story. As a review, by telling the story based on when cash literally happens, the story is told using the cash basis of accounting. Telling the story based on when revenues are actually earned and when expenses are actually incurred, a story is told using accrual accounting. Investors usually want to see the story told using the accrual basis of accounting in order to make an investment decision concerning the business. For more videos like this, visit AccountingWITT.com.